Hello there guys, it's Joe here. Welcome back to Fernbus Coach Simulator. Today you find us sat at, where are we? Konstanz. It's South Germany. Hello, here we are. We are not actually on a route today, but we are going to be having a look at the Bavarian Castle DLC, which has recently hit our Fernbus system, Hohenschwangau. There we are, Bavarian Castle. Apparently it's a site, and we can go there. We can discover a bus stop. We're not on a route, purely because the closest I've got to Munich and this area is Dresden, and in the career mode. It would be a long route down here. In fact, we could potentially do that. Maybe we'll do that some other time. But obviously it took us forever to go from here to here, so I thought from here to here it's going to take even longer. Also, one thing to mention, Happy Christmas Day everybody, 25th of December, hooray! It's finally here, regardless of what you are doing for Christmas. I hope you have an absolutely fantastic day. Whether we're allowed to mingle or not, who knows, because at time of recording we are allowed to, but then we might not be allowed to. So yeah, hope you're all having a fantastic time, guys. And if not, I'm here, you know, go and view. I've got tons of videos. There's at least 24 hours of viewing time there, so you can just watch them. Yay, fantastic. If you feel that you want to send me a Christmas present, you can do so in the link below. There is a little link to a PayPal account. Anything you wish to donate, please feel free. And we're in the Toyota, well, it's not called the Toyota, it is a Toyota, it's based on a real life bus. It's called the BB40 in this. There's no Toyota logos anywhere, so I don't actually know if they managed to get permission to use it. But this type it's a Toyota minibus type thing you find in Japan. We don't have any in the UK, or at least I've not seen one. You can tell this by the fact that I'm not in a hysterical bout of laughter. So let's get going. Let's see, can you remember how to set the... I'm not in service on the front, because of course this is a not in service trip. Page up. No, that's... remember, it's like one of these funny gear... It's a full-on gear stick, that's how we are. Sounds like we're driving a transit van, doesn't it? Now please do excuse me, but I am going to keep consulting the map here, because to my knowledge there is no way of, you know, setting a destination. Can we click you? No, not having it. So we need to turn right, keep going forward. Okay, that's how we're going to get there. Fair dues. Right, my sense of direction is famously good, actually. I'm not good at a lot of things, but direction, I can just about manage. Now, this town I've not explored at all, Konstanz. Again, on the career mode, I'm pretty much, in terms of the progression I've made in career mode, what you've seen on my YouTube is the progression I've made on career mode for this game. I mean, I do like this game. I think it's fantastic. The graphics, the coaches, particularly with the DLC, which I've, you know, slowly acquired since I've been doing the YouTube. I haven't bought any of the DLCs at all. But I thought, you know what, we'll try that, seeing as we're doing some YouTube, we'll get some more interesting coaches. But it's not a game that I've felt that I've been absolutely able to completely lose myself in, if that makes sense. You know, like Transport Fever, you can just be playing for hours, same as Train Simulator. You know, you can just spend hours on it. Train Simulator's a bit more difficult because you've always got a little clock in the corner and eventually you run out of track. But, you know, OMSI, I can just happily sit and whiz up and down on a route for hours on end. This, I've not. In the same way Euro Truck Sim, I've never really lost myself in that. Hang on, we are going right here, aren't we? There we go. Pop the old handbrake on. We are going right. Yes, we are. Thank you. So what's down here? Nothing. potentially another bit of DLC. Ooh. It's probably available, but like I said, I've not treated myself to any of it yet. I was actually hoping that we could have some snow, you know, so it'd be a bit festive. I mean, we've not had snow at all, really. But it was not giving me snow as one of the options for the weather. So I left it on sunny. I think it's on dynamic weather, so, you know, if it decides that we're going to have some rain, then rain we shall have. I'm hoping it won't, because I'd like to be able to, you know, admire the view. From what I've had a look on this DLC, the views are good, and there's a big camera on the map, which suggests that screenshots are good here. I mean, this was released on the 18th of December, so I'm sorry that I've not done a video a little bit quicker than this, to be honest with you. I mean, last week on Fernbus, we obviously had the sensational... what do you call it? The New Netherlands DLC. This little minibus sounds like it's about to blow up, doesn't it? And the problem that we have is that we do not have cruise control. Why the giddy gumdrops did you pick this thing to drive? Well, much like the Toyota BB40. You're just cutting me up there. Thanks. Much like the BB40, this Bavarian Castle DLC is free. Head on over to the Steam store if you do have Fernbus and download it for free. Much like the BB40, this is also free. I mean, could you imagine actually paying money to drive this thing? So yeah, if you like what you see here, just go and download it, because the only thing that you're going to lose out on is space on your hard drive. Yeah, you're not going to actually have to splash out any English pounds or European euros, because it's free. Get it downloaded. Right, where are we going? We're going right again here, aren't we? I mean, the rev counter's just full on. You know, it's... Oh, hang on. One thing about this thing that I have noted is that it handles, and this is going to shock you what I'm about to say, it handles a lot better than the big coaches. Well, of course it does, you blithering imbecile, because it's smaller. Yeah, you may have a point there. But, you know, it's not so much... It's a little bit faster. Again, it's smaller, but you can throw it around corners more. Not that I particularly come, you know, when I think of I want to race vehicles, Fernbus Coach Simulator isn't, you know, the immediate one that springs to mind. If I want to race cars, or race fast, drive fast even, I'll load Forza Horizon 4, because that's a great game. It's not really something that Fernbus isn't the first game that springs to mind when I think I want to throw it round corners and go fast, but sometimes, particularly on like Tourist Bus Simulator, where it is your company. You want to get it done fast, because then you can get another job and you can, you know, you can be earning more money. This one seems to keep up on the motorway a lot better. The problem is, like I said, no cruise control, so I'm forever having to sit here absolutely revving the nuts off it. I mean, the engine sounds like it's going to blow up at any given moment. I'm really hoping it doesn't. Yeah, it would be interesting in terms of viewing for you guys. Blown up and falling down the side of a mountain. God, how will we cope? 100 kilometres an hour. I mean, what's that? In miles an hour, that's 75, isn't it, roughly? I mean, I'm using my Transport Fever conversion there, that the standard tracks are 75 miles an hour or 100 kilometres an hour, roughly. Yeah, that's about right. So they've been told you have to slow down. I mean, we can't even do that in this country. 70 everywhere. I mean, you speak to people and they probably will tell you that they drive faster on the motorway. Good grief, I wouldn't even dream of it, he says with a completely straight face. Never drive faster than 70. Are you mad? Yeah, the Mercedes in front finally had enough and then cut the van up. / minibus. It's a bit of good driving, that Mercedes. Right, let's overtake, because I reckon we can. The horn is suitably van-like, isn't it? And we're going to be causing road rage behind, so we'd better move back over to the slow people's lane. I mean, if we look out to the right, you'll see this spectacular scenery. We don't really get that much from the left. We've got this kind of green thing going on. But there's a lake over there. Very pretty, isn't it? With the mountains in the background. Now, from my very limited geography knowledge, I would hazard a guess that that was Lake Konstanz. Well, it could be. I've heard that Konstanz has a lake. That could potentially be it, given that we were just in Konstanz. Oh, hang on, so we can go right to Stuttgart. Is that a real place? See, that's a ridiculous thing to say. I know Stuttgart's a real place. Oh, no, we're not going right, sorry. That will take you left. As you can see on the minimap, it will bend you under the road. I was just thinking, because obviously we're driving along the bottom of the map, aren't we? I know Stuttgart's a real place in real life. But I didn't know if it had been added to the map. I thought that coming off and turning right, maybe it's not been built yet. Nope, hang on. Oh, a bit of chain reaction. Is that Diana Ross? Right, it's a proper coach holiday now, isn't it? All we're missing is the people. Well, do you know what? Next time I'll do a drive with people on. I just was conscious. I don't want to make it too long. You know, I mean, this is, because it's a free DLC, you're not getting an entire region. It's a, whoa, corner. Yeah, you couldn't do this in a Man Lions coach. What was I saying then? Something of vital importance, of course. Because everything I say is incredibly important. Oh, hang on, you're speeding. Let's just slow down. Oh yeah, so you don't get a full new region. Which is why I thought we won't do a proper route today. We'll just do a little free drive, as it were. You do... I've never used one of these free DLCs before. I should do, really, shouldn't I? There's no point in me showcasing some of the other ones, because they've been out that long now. That, you know, you'll be like, well, yeah, there's no point, you know, tuning in to watch that, because we've been there, done that. So, yeah, I've not really downloaded any of the other free ones. Maybe I will. If you want me to, let me know in the comments if that's something you would watch. I mean, obviously, I've said it before and I'll say it again. When it comes to the videos, I am very much your bitch, as it were. You know, if I don't produce things you want to watch, then you won't watch and there's very little point in me producing it, is there? Well, that's a hill and a half, isn't it? I don't think we'd get up there in this little Toyota. Whoa, round on two wheels. Proper suspension, that, isn't it? I hope we're still going the right direction. I think we are. We wait for the four-way junction, don't we? How are we doing that? We're slowing down without braking. What have you done? Just put it into gear one. Ah, we can't get up the hill now. This is a very unhappy sounding bus. It's not a bus, is it? It's just a van. Oh, there we go. We're leveling out now. We can pick up some speed. I don't know what the thinking behind, you know, these green things in the middle of the central reservation are. I mean, I'm sure that they're there in real life in this particular bit of Autobahn. They're not particularly nice, are they? You can do it, little van. Keep going. Keep going. I mean, I'd be lying if I said that I'd not driven this before. On my personal save on Tourist Bus Simulator, I do have a fleet of these. Because they're cheap, and they do the job. You know, so this is all I have, pretty much. I don't have any big coaches. Partly because on Tourist Bus Sim, you very rarely need a big coach in the beginning. A lot of the jobs are like, oh yeah, we need you to transport three people to the airport. And you're like, well, what's the point in taking a, you know, VDL Futura for that? Well, yeah, you answered your own question there. There is no point in taking a VDL Futura for three people. Alright, maybe I'm exaggerating. You get a few Model 3 on, but, nope, what's happening here? You're going to cut me up, aren't you? Well, no, I can't even go into that lane. Well, don't say I didn't try. That VW Passat's going to just sit and tailgate the Volvo in front. Now, I believe that I need to turn right down here. This is the bit where I need to turn right, isn't it? Oh, hello, fellow Flixbus driver. Yeah, so I need to go right again here, because otherwise we'll end up going straight on. Yeah, so we just go straight around, and I believe that Bavarian Castle is up there somewhere. I'm going to try and not look at the big map again. Do it from memory. So this is like the big four junction, isn't it? So we need to turn right here. Oop, way round on two wheels. You're not for letting me in, are you? What is it with VW drivers today? Yep, another Flixbus coming the other way. Whoa! You don't just slam on a, you know, on a slip road. That's not on. Well, we got round him anyway in the end, didn't we? See, I don't get too close to the lorry in front because he just slams on again. Well, not him, but I mean, there was a bit of phantom braking on the last section of the road, wasn't there? Oh, and another one. Hello, colleague. You didn't really look at them that time, did you? You just looked kind of upwards. This is definitely one of the most picturesque sections of Autobahn that I've driven on. A lot of it is uphill, which is a good sign for Bavarian Castle. Oop, what's happening with the lighting? I'm hoping that the trees are going to start. I mean, obviously you can see up there. That is a mountain with snow on it. I'm hoping maybe the trees will get some snow on them as we get higher up. Now, I don't honestly know what to expect here because I've never driven this route. I mean, it's not really a route, is it? I've never driven this particular section of map. I mean, most of the videos, like I said, I put out to you, it's the first time I've been over a route. So I don't really know what to expect. It's dreadful when we get there, you know, really bad. You know, it's just a car park where past evening people get up to questionable activities. You know, if it just turns out to be a car park looking over a valley where people get up to those questionable activities, then I am sorry that I've wasted your time. No real point in us overtaking, is there? I was just looking at the speedo and, you know, is there any point? Probably not. You'll just annoy all the people that aren't real. Oh, hang on, where are we going? Innsbruck? Well, that can't be right. We've got to be obviously coming off here, haven't we? Because I don't think I've got the Austrian DLC. When I say I don't think I have, I know full well I haven't. Let's just do what I said I wasn't going to do, and let's just check that little mini map. Ah, right, so we definitely are coming off here to the site of the Bavarian Castle. Right, well, okay. Which way were we turning? Were we going off and straight forward? Okay, I can cope with that. To Schwangau. An hour around this corner, are you mad? I wouldn't even attempt that in a car, let alone in a Toyota BB40. Oh dear, that... If you're turning right here, that clearly means you've gone the wrong way, doesn't it? Because you're going back on yourself on the motorway. Mr. Blue Lexus there. We've seen you. Ah, so there we go. There is the Bavarian Castle. Very picturesque indeed. And a nice big bridge. I believe this is a famous bridge. So we're going up there. Hell, it's going to be a steep climb if we're getting all the way up to the castle. Oh well, we can do it. With our 1.6-litre diesel engine that we seem to have in this thing. Perhaps a bit optimistic taking the corner at that speed, Joe. Yeah, you're definitely going to have to slow down for this bit. Oh, what a little picturesque village. Oh, hang on, speeding past a police officer, that's never a good idea, is it? Right, well, let's carry on straight up forward. Or straight on, we can explore up there. Schloss, that means waterfall. So, yeah, I guess we'll be going up there then, if we're headed towards a Schloss. But we'll carry on down here and see where it takes us. I mean, there's a little loop at the end of the road. So, goodness only knows. Perhaps it's just literally a turnaround. It is quite literally just a turnaround. Oh, hang on. There we go. That is the turnaround. Whoa! Let's pull in to the side. Can they overtake us? No, they can't. Well, that's nice, isn't it? Very pretty. Nice bit of a nice lake. Nice view up to the castle there. I reckon we can take a nicer shot than that. So let's continue upward. Policeman's going, hello, 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 what's going on here then? Getting in trouble. Right, so hang on, we're going round to the right here. Whoa, let's do some indicating there. Whoa. Oh my god, what's happened to the road? We appear to be driving on what's left of the road rather than, an actual road. Whoa. I mean, this is fantastic, isn't it? In terms of, I should really have brought something bigger, like a massive triaxle neo plan. But you've, well, there's one rule on this channel. We don't drive triaxles if we can help it, because they're scary. Too big. Yeah, that's the rule of thumb on this channel. Can we, have we got anything, you know, another view? No? Can't see the castle anymore, never mind. But we'll keep going. Speeding, again. Well, we can't just sit at 50 kilometres an hour, we've got places to be. What do they think we are? Law-abiding citizens? Oh, now you're going too slow. You've got to put your foot down when you come to a hill. That's how the laws of physics work. Yeah, the BB40's not happy. It's definitely not happy on this hill. I mean, I am driving flat out now. And we've got to 44. That might be all you're getting. No, 45. So long as it doesn't get any steeper than this, we should be alright. We're approaching the loop at the top. I'm surprised we don't have a big queue of cars behind us, to be honest with you. Though I haven't seen any AI traffic coming the other way, so maybe, just maybe, AI traffic is not permitted up this road. I don't know what we're going to find at the top. I'm hoping that we're going to get some sort of a nice view. Oh, we can carry on. Can we walk up there? We should be able to walk up there, shouldn't we? Right, there we go. Engine off. Gear in neutral position. There we go, thank you. Get out the coach. Who's beeping? How on earth can we come to this really tranquil place and still hear car beeping? Right, so, Schloss Waterfall, down here. Oh, here is the castle. Oh, fantastic. Now I'm panicking that maybe my German's not as good as I thought it was, and Schloss means castle. Oh, hang on, yeah. It doesn't mean waterfall, does it, you blithering idiot? Oh, maybe it does. I'm absolutely sure that Schloss meant waterfall. But I might be getting that confused with the Icelandic for foss, which is... that means waterfall. Let's see, isn't that pretty? Looking down over Germany there. All a bit foggy, isn't it? I mean, I'm assuming we can't bring our coach down here. Well, you can't. It's a public footpath. Well, it's a public footpath that's missing the public. Oh, here they are. There's people here. Ah, very nice. TML Studio, some fizzy drink. A sort of Coca-Cola logo. Mm-hmm. Yeah, alright then. They're all sat here, not sure what they're waiting for. But they are real people that move, you know, and animate. Oh, that's nice. Are we supposed to drive our bus round here? Oh, hang on, where can we... Ah, we can actually drive up here. Well, I'm sorry, but we've done it on foot. Can we go in? No, we can't. Right, well, I'll tell you what, where's the camera? We'll walk up to this camera, and then if not, we will go back. And, there we go. Can we go in? Oh, well, this is fantastic. Yeah, you'd never turn a coach around in here, would you? What's up at the top? So it's one of those scenes where oh, there's nothing up here. Ah, okay, fair dues. Right. Well, that, just looking over there, I hadn't clocked that, but that's very nice. So we're going to go and have a look at that next. So shame I can't run any faster. Can we, you know, you're jogging like you've kind of wet yourself. And I know that the Toyota BB40 didn't have any conveniences on board, but can you not... it would be nice if he, you know, wasn't running like... Well, I suppose not even wet yourself, like you've done something even more unforgivable. Well, just don't make eye contact with those people. They've all gone. Where are they all gone? And they literally all just walked off. I reckon they've nicked the bus, you know. They've been stranded up here for that long. That they've, you know, that, oh, it's another human being, yeah. Viva nix the bus. It's a mildly offensive accent, but it'll be fine. It'll be fine. I always think so long as you're willing to laugh at yourself, then it should be fine to laugh at other people. And having my Yorkshire accent, which every now and then does shine through. I do try and hide it and try and talk a bit more Queen's English. It doesn't always happen, I'm not going to lie to you. But I get enough Mickey taken out of me for my accent that I think it's alright to laugh at other people. Right, the coach is not there. It's not there. If it's despawned, I'll panic is what I'll do, because I don't know how to respawn another. Oh, no, it's there. To be fair, they probably came to steal the coach and saw what we brought and thought, do you know what, we'll walk. Right, can we get up there? You're never going to get up there in this, but it doesn't mean to say that we're not going to try. Ooh, you left the door open, that's brave. Right. Okay. I reckon we're not going to get past these bollard things. Yeah. Okay. Handbrake on. We'll have to run up the hill then. That's a shame. We can't get a nice shot of the coach up. Yeah, you're not getting through there. Well, maybe for the thumbnail, I'll have to be a bit more creative. See, I mean, I do like this. I think this is absolutely fantastic. Floating hedge. Hello. Very nice. You know, the attention to detail is absolutely brilliant. I especially like, and they've not done it there, but I like the fact they've put a rock jutting out so that you can sit flat. They've not done it with that bench, so maybe that was accidental. You know, I'm loving this attention to detail, that they just, you know, this area of map that you can explore. You just, oh my god, what's happened there? Oh, dearie me. Well, it turns out that you can't explore it because there's, good god, oh, for someone that's scared of heights, this is not a good, that's not good at all. Go into the bus, it says in the bottom left hand corner. There is nothing I'd rather do than go into the bus. Right, let's, how the hell do we get back up there now? Well, let's try walking off the edge and see what happens. Oh my godfathers! We are an invincible bus driver. I don't know if we're meant to be here. I don't know if the, you know, the, can we go down the river? Can we? Nope, we're stuck now. We're stuck! Yep, we can't go any further. Right, well, there we go. That's... Words fail me, I don't know what to say to that. Yeah, we're very much stuck. Fancy putting that in and not being allowed to walk across it. How ridiculous. Right, well, there we go. Thank you for watching. Oh, I'm floating. Well, there you go. That's a bug that TML probably didn't know was there, because nobody in the right mind will have tried to walk over that bridge. But, yeah, and now they do know it's there. Thank you so much for watching. I do hope that you enjoyed the video. If you did, why not click the like button and subscribe so that you never miss out. Other than that, until next time, cheerio, goodbye for now.